Welcome back. My name is Tammy, and today we're looking at weight-based drug calculations, which means calculating. So before we start, take a moment and subscribe to the channel today so that you will get notification when the next video is available. Second, make sure you download the free quiz. It's right there in the description box, because we're going to work on those first two questions together. Now, when it comes to weight-based calculations, sometimes people like to figure out smaller steps and then put it all together at the end. Others like to put it all in one long formula, and we're going to do that as well using dimensional analysis today. So once you're ready, meet me at the board. All right, so we have our practice questions here, and let's start with number one. A patient that's ordered heparin 50 units per kilogram for a pulmonary embolism. My patient weighs 87 pounds, and I have a vial available of 5,000 units per ml. So what am I looking to find? I'm looking to find how many mLs I will need. Second thing is, what do I know? Well, I know I have 50 units per kilogram, and that's my desired dose, but I have a patient that only weighs 87 pounds, and what I need to do is convert that into kilograms. So if I complete the math right here, I can see that 87 pounds is equal to 39.54 kilograms. So now I can use that to finish off my desired dose. I want 50 units for every kilogram. So I'm multiplying 39.54 times by 50, and I get 1977 units. That is my desired dose. Now I can set up a proportion. I'm wanting to solve for how many mLs will give me 1977 units when I know 1 ml is 5,000 units. I'm going to cross multiply here to get rid of the denominators. 5,000 units times by my questionable ml is equal to 1977 units times by 1 ml. Now I want to isolate my unknown dosage, so I'll divide both sides of the equation by 5,000 units. And in doing so, that will get rid of the 5,000 units on the left-hand side of the equation. On the right-hand side of the equation, I can get rid of units. So now I have my unknown dose is equal to 1977 mils over 5,000. And this is equal to 0.3954 mLs, rounding that up to 0.40 mLs. Now let's take a look at how we do it with dimensional analysis, where we have all the steps in one equation. So I'm still trying to solve for how many mLs I'm going to need. So I'm going to start off with my question mark. How many mLs per dose? First, I'm going to put in my weight conversion. 87 pounds. I know per kilogram it's 2.2 pounds. Pounds crosses off. I'm left with kilos. I also know that I have a desired dose of 50 units per kilogram. And in what I have available to me is 5,000 units per 1 ml. So I'm just going to write this in so you can see that. My weight conversion, my desired dose, and my dose available. And now I've crossed off all the units I can. I'm left with mils. I can now solve. So 87 times 1 times 50 is equal to 4,350 mLs. And on the bottom, 2.2 times by 5,000 is equal to 11,000. And when I further factor this out, I get 0.3954 mLs, which will round up to 0.4. All right, here we have a nurse practitioner that's ordered a dopamine infusion to treat a patient's low blood pressure. The order is for dopamine at 6 micrograms per kilogram per minute. I have a patient who weighs 65 kilograms and an available dose of 400 milligrams per 250 mils. So what is the IV rate in mils per hour? And I want to round that to the nearest whole number. The first thing I want to know is, what is my desired dose? Because I need to finish this calculation. 6 mics per kilo times by 65 kilograms will give me my total desired dose of 390 mics per minute. The dose that I have on hand is 400 milligrams in 250 mils. Now this milligrams doesn't match with my micrograms, so I need to do a conversion to put my dosage into micrograms. I know that in 1 milligram, I have 1,000 micrograms. And so that gives me a total of 400,000 micrograms in my 250 mL bag, and now my units match. The next thing I'm going to do is put this into my equation. I'm looking for mils per hour. I know I have 250 mL, and in the is 400,000 micrograms. I'm looking for a dose of 390 micrograms, and the goal here is to cross off micrograms, and I have that in every minute. I need to do a time conversion from minutes to hours so that I can get my answer in mils per hour. So if I do this calculation, 250 times by 390 times by 60, I get 5,850,000 mils over 400,000 hours. Continue to calculate that out. My answer is 14.6 mils per hour. It asks me to round to the nearest whole number, so my answer is 15 mils per hour. So let's look how this would be put together using dimensional analysis from the beginning. I have a 65 kilogram patient and I need 6 mics per kilo per minute. This is my conversion into my desired dose. Next, I have an available dose of 400 milligrams in 250 mils and I need to convert this into micrograms. So my available dose and its conversion gets put into the formula. And then finally, I have to do a time conversion because I'm still working in minutes and I need to calculate that into hours. Now that I've eliminated everything except for mils per hour, I can go ahead and solve. So this time I'm going to multiply everything on the top. 65 times 6 times 250 times 1 times 60 is equal to 5,850,000 mils. And I multiply everything on the bottom. 400 times 1,000, 400,000 hours. Further solve this calculation. You can see that when I complete this calculation, I am left with 14.6 mils per hour. The question asked me to round to the nearest whole number, 15 mils per hour. So that's the end of the lesson, but don't go yet. Comment below, leave me an idea as to whether this video helped you. If you have suggestions for a future video, please put them there as well. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, there'll be a link popping up. And if you're looking for a little inspiration, watch the video on Dear Future Nurses. It's a video made for students by students. Until next time, make it a great day.